Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In our last video, we have seen what is OEmbed API and how to use OEmbed API to embed the resources to the website. In this video, let us see how to embed tweets and timelines to the website through OEmbed API. The tweets and timelines can be embedded into the website in multiple ways. The OEmbed API helps to embed the dynamic tweets and timelines programmatically through tweet ID or URL. Last video, we have seen the details on OEmbed API. For Twitter, this is the API endpoint, https://publish.twitter.com/OEmbed, and these are the URL schemes, mainly status and moments URL. Let us now see how to embed the tweets into the website. These are the individual tweets URL. So again, the OEmbed URL, publish.twitter.com/OEmbed, then the URL parameter. So this is the tweet URL, twitter.com, then the Twitter username, then status, then the tweet ID. The same thing as we discussed earlier, the tweet can be embedded through the tweet URL or tweet ID. So this is the tweet ID. So if you see here, there is no username here, Twitter, then status, then tweet ID. Same way, the moments also can be embedded. So this is the moments URL. So even you can pass some additional parameters. My case, hide media. Hide media equal to true hides the media card inside the tweet. This will returns the JSON response along with the HTML embed code, and that can be embedded into the website. These are some of the parameters. The first one is URL, the URL of the tweet to be embedded. Next one is max width, maximum width of a rendered tweet in pixels. Then next one is hide media. When set to true, T or 1, the media links are hided. Omit script, when set to true, T or 1, the script, the widget.js script will not be returned. Our web page should be taken care of, including the widget.js. Then align, this specifies the embedded tweet alignment related to the parent element. Example, left, right, center, or none. Next one is related, the comma separated list of Twitter usernames related to your content. Next one is lang, the language in which the HTML should be written. The default is EN. You can specify any supported, Twitter supported language, so in which the HTML will be written. Next one is theme, the theme in which the tweet should be displayed. Light or dark, you can specify, the default one is light. Next is widget type and DNT. Let me quickly access this specific URL. Okay, so JSON is downloaded. Let me open this. Here the HTML, I'm going to copy this. This is the embed HTML. Let me decode this. Okay. Let me go to the HTML file. I'm going to add it here. Save this. Let me go and access the page. Okay, now the tweet is displayed. Let me add some parameter now. I'm going to add hide media equal to true. So let's see the difference. Okay, let me open the JSON. Again, same thing. I'm going to copy this HTML. Decode this. Okay, copy this. Let me replace this. Okay. Yeah, now if you see that media is not displayed, only the thread is displayed. Add the additional parameters based on your need. Let us now see embedding the timeline into the website. OEmbed API supports different timelines, user, list, collection and likes. These are the OEmbed API URLs. Again, same thing, publish.twitter.com/OEmbed. Then URL, this one is for user timeline. This is the user ID. Then the next one is for list. Then the third one is for collection. Then the last one is for likes. Some of the additional parameters. URL we have already seen, the URL of the Twitter timeline to be embedded. Then widget type, this is only for collection timelines. So if you set to grid, it will display the tweets in a grid layout. Then limit, you can limit the number of tweets inside the timeline. So display up to n items where n is a value between 1 and 20. Then max width, max height, again omit script, language, related, theme, then border color. Then you can specify Chrome. Chrome will take multiple options, no header, no footer, no borders, no scroll bar, then transparent. Even you can combine multiple options, space separated, no header, then space, no footer. The next one is aria polite. So the possible values are polite, assertive and rude. Then DNT. Let me quickly open one of the URL. So I'm going with the user timeline. Fine, the JSON is downloaded. Let me open that. I'm going to copy this. Then decode it. Okay, let me go and copy this to the HTML. Yeah, now if you see the timeline is displayed, all the tweets under that user will be get displayed. The same way, you can even specify other timelines, list, collection and likes. Hiding of the media is not supported for timeline APIs, should be implemented through some custom solutions. Also, hashtags will not be directly embedded through OEmbed API. Again, custom solutions should be implemented to embed the hashtags to the website. The Twitter OEmbed API can be used to embed dynamic tweets and timelines programmatically to the website. Based on the tweet ID or tweet URL, you can connect to the OEmbed API endpoint and get the HTML embed to dynamically display the tweets inside the website. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video.